taro cake, and it's using this vegetable. Now, you may have seen this in an Asian supermarket, and it kind of looks like a coconut. It's from the radish family, and the Chinese believe it's got really good healing health qualities. This is the root. We're going to use this in our taro cake. Now, there's a bit of a process here, but it's worth doing. Right, so, frying pan on. Heat a tablespoon of rice bran oil while prepping the rest of the delicious ingredients. It's Chinese sausage, we call it lap chong, and it's a pork sausage. There's lots of fat through here, so it's very oily. And it's got loads of spices as well, but it's really unique. And if you think about it, all cultures have got some form of sausage which is unique to them. This is ours.
Dice it up and chuck it in, along with some rehydrated dried shrimps and shiitake mushrooms. Whilst those fry, I can start prepping my taro root.
So, taro is a really unusual flavour. It's kind of savoury and sweet at the same time. It's a tough one, this one. And you see, it's quite stringy. It's almost like a bark. Very unusual root vegetable, but it's delicious. Very, very earthy. You kind of know it's going to be good for you. Now, a tiny bit of oil. We're just going to fry off the taro. And then add in 2 cups of water. And then you're going to boil that down. Never, ever let the water evaporate to nothing. You always want a little bit in there.
There's one final element that will bring all of these ingredients together, the batter.
So in here, I've got rice flour, really important, not plain flour. I've got some Chinese five spice, chicken powder, which is just basically a bouillon, a base.
Add a teaspoon each of pepper, salt, and sugar.
A dash of sesame oil. And then 2 cups of water, and I'm gonna bring that together.
Once fully combined, lob in the fried lap chong, mushroom and shrimp mix.
It's like a savoury Christmas pudding.
Then bang in the softened taro root.
I'm just going to mix this through.
Tip the whole lot into a greased baking dish.
I'm just patting it down now just to get some of the air out because it will be sliced up after it's steamed and then fried. Right, so now, ooh, she's hot. In. Oh. She's gonna sit in steam now for about 60 minutes and afterwards it'll be a set piece of blocked taro with all of those beautiful flavours running through, and then we can slice it up and fry it.
Once it's had its time, leave to cool at room temperature.
Right, so this is what it looks like after it's been cooling. Normally, what we would do is we would cut it into squares, but because I'm the more fashionable one in our family, I'm gonna slice it into polenta-style chips and then serve it all wedged up. So, I'm just gonna get some straight lines. We're not gonna waste any of this, don't worry. Oh, she's good. Look at that. And that's how I'm going to serve them when they're fried, that kind of shape. Smells delicious. It's the five spice that's overriding there. So you can see lap chong, shiitake mushroom, the taro, all running through. It's such a beautiful, beautiful looking dish. So pan on, a bit more oil.
Fry the slices until beautifully golden brown and crispy. Trust me, it's worth the effort.